Fermat's theorem. Fermat's theorem states that if P is a prime number, if P is a prime number and A is any positive integer, only one condition, that this A does not divide P, or this P does not divide P. So if P is a prime number and A is any positive integer such that this P is not divisible by A or A is not divisible by P, then A power P minus 1 is congruent to 1 mod P. So Fermat's theorem holds true if P is a prime number and A is any integer that is not divisible by P. For example, if we take P is equal to 5 and A is equal to 2. So obviously P does not divide A or A does not divide P. So A power P minus 1 is congruent to 1 mod P. We'll substitute the values. 2 power P minus 1 is congruent to 1 mod P. 2 power 4 is congruent to 1 mod. We'll substitute the value of P here also. 1 mod 5. 2 power 4, 16. Is congruent to 1 mod 5. We'll check whether this is right. Fermat's theorem holds true or not. 16, when it is divided by 5, we should get this as the remainder. 16, 3 times 15, remainder 1. Yes, Fermat's theorem holds true. Fermat's theorem holds true. We'll take one more example also. Let P equal to 7 and A is equal to 3. So obviously when we look at these values, it's clear that Fermat's theorem will also hold true. So this is A power P minus 1 is congruent to 1 mod P. A, 3 power 7 minus 1 is congruent to 1 mod P. Value of P here is 7. So 3 power 6 is congruent to 1 mod 7. So I am rewriting this 3 power 6 as 3 power 2 into 3 power 2 into 3 power 2. Anyway, mathematically if you solve any step, any approach will give you the same result. So 3 power 2 is equal to 9. 9 into 9 into 9 is congruent to 1 mod 7. As per modular arithmetic rule, so you can simplify this. 9 mod 7 can also be written as 2 into 2 into 2. It means 9, when you divide it with 7, 7 1 times 7, the remainder is 2. You are just replacing it with the remainder. This 1 mod 7. 2 into 2 into 2. 4 into 2, 8 is congruent to 1 mod 7. Let's check. 8, when it is divided by 7, 7 1 times 7, and the remainder is 7. Yes, you get this remainder. Hence, Fermat's theorem holds true.